The IntelliClimate is awesome. It is constantly monitoring the temperature, the humidity, the CO2, and the light levels in your grow room. It's very simple to use. You hit the menu button to go into your settings. This is your today's schedule. So you can choose light banks. You can have two light banks. You can alternate your light banks or lose light bank two or light bank one. You have your light on time and then your light duration. So you can determine the time of day that your lights will come on and how long they will stay on. Then you can set your day temperatures. And your night drop. So the idea being that if it's 73 degrees during the day, that it's gonna drop down to 64 degrees at night. You have a daytime humidity, a nighttime humidity, and a relative humidity max. These are the settings that you've put in. The targets are determined by the intelligence of the IntelliClimate. So they will automatically adjust 24/7 depending on how all of the different peripherals in your room are working. Overrides. So if you want to force your fan on, you simply go into edit, click force on, and the fans will come on. Go back in, put back onto auto, and then the IntelliClimate is controlling them again. You can force on fan one, fan two, your CO2, your dehumidifiers, and your lights. You have alarms, so you can set your alarms if your temperature goes too high or too low, if you have a minimum temperature and a maximum temperature. You have the same for your humidity and your CO2. Minimum CO2 and maximum CO2. Your clock settings, and then your configuration. Your log times, temperature units, date format, VPD units. If you want to mute or allow the buzzer on the unit itself, screen contrast, your backlight, and what's installed. So here we tell it what we have connected. We have a fan one. Are we using a fan two or air conditioning? If we have a heater, CO2 sensors, CO2 injection, CO2 extraction, dehumidifiers, humidifiers or foggers, lights, two banks, outside temperature sensors, or a second environment sensor. We have an intruder alarm. And if we don't have a dehumidifier, how do we want it to dehumidify? Then we can also set up our CO2 configuration. So on each of the environment sensors, you can scale it so that you can actually calibrate the built-in sensors to make sure that they are working the proper levels. Exiting back, we'll get you back to your main screen, where you can see all of your readings, and these are your targets.